Hello and welcome to this video on Mimic Design Flow in ADS. My name is Jack Sifri, and in this video I will demonstrate ADS Desktop LVS. This is our complete Mimic Desktop Design Flow in ADS. It starts from top-level system specs and ends with successful delivery of a Mimic in its final environment, packaged, inserted in a module, and mounted on a board. On the previous video, I had demonstrated desktop DRC in ADS. Now, let us take a look at desktop LVS. It is crucial to have a good LVS tool within your desktop design environment, so you can ensure that the layout mask you submit to the foundry completely and accurately matches with everything you have designed, modeled, and simulated on the schematic page. ADS contains two separate LVS tools that run within its design environment. The first is the ADS Desktop LVS, which is native in the ADS install. It is part of ADS. The second is the Caliber LVS, which is tightly integrated into the ADS environment and supports running LVS jobs on a remote server and viewing the results in ADS. This video demo focuses on the ADS Desktop LVS, which is natively included in ADS and can be run easily and at any time during the Mimic design phase. ADS Desktop LVS allows you to run LVS and verify your designs early in your design cycle, at any time and as often as you want, so there will be no surprises at the end. And your design IP is always protected and stays right at your desktop. ADS Desktop LVS can be run from either the schematic or the layout page, and it can be run on any design containing components from a PDK library elements, hierarchical components, or custom models. ADS Desktop LVS fully supports hierarchical design check. Its analysis is based on database comparison and does not require a rule deck. The designs do not need to be synchronized with ADS layout schematic synchronization. This means that ADS Desktop LVS can compare a layout and schematic from different designs. ADS Desktop LVS runs fast, and it detects component, nodal, and parameter mismatches. They're all easily accessed from organized tabs as shown here. It also allows you to save the complete LVS report as a text file and email it or print it out. Now, please allow me to demo this for you in ADS. This is the same two-stage Mimic power amplifier for LTE applications, which I had used in the previous DRC video demo. Let me now run LVS on it. Notice on the layout view, this drain bias pad is wired and connected to both FET1 and FET2. Similarly, this gate bias pad is connected to both FET1 and FET2. So, in other words, the two FETs share the same drain bias pad and the same gate bias pad. But on the schematic page, this is different. The bias pins of both FETs are separated and they are not connected together. So this would create nodal discrepancies between the layout and the schematic. As for the component count, notice the drain pad, the gate pad, and the two RF pads with their ground vias. These are included on the layout page. But notice they do not exist on the schematic page. So this would create component mismatch between the layout and the schematic. So from the tools menu, from either the layout page or the schematic page, I can launch ADS Desktop LVS. All I have to do is click on Run. Notice the LVS results page. It points to these missing pads and grounds that I have mentioned above. and it also points out the gate and drain bias lines nodal discrepancies on the schematic and the layout pages. If you click on the Component Mismatch tab, it will list to you all the component mismatched elements. And if you click on the Nodal Mismatch tab, it will list to you all the nodal mismatch elements. Also, notice the Auto Zoom feature automatically locates and zoom on any error you select. So here, I went ahead and fixed these problems. This revised schematic shows that I have added the DC and RF pads and grounds on the schematic, and I also connected the two drains and the two gates together to one common drain pad and one common gate pad, exactly as they were realized on the layout page. So now, when I run LVS on this fixed design, you can see I get zero errors with a complete match between layout and schematic. We see the component count perfectly matches up between the layout and the schematic on the full design and on all the subnetworks. Let me now illustrate to you a parameter mismatch case. On the layout page, I use the Edit in Place feature to edit and change the width of this line, which is part of the input matching subnetwork in this hierarchical design. I change it from 5 microns to 50 microns width, as shown here. I will not make this change on the schematic page, and I will not synchronize my design to the schematic. So I know now that I have a parameter mismatch between the layout and the schematic. So let me now run LVS again. And here we go. You can see that LVS caught this parameter mismatch and reported it as shown here on the Parameter Mismatch tab. So here in the Parameter tab listing, it is shown that there are two parameter mismatches between the layout and the schematic: the width of the lines and their corresponding inductance. And with the Auto Zoom feature, once you select an error, it highlights it and zooms on it in both views, the layout and the schematic views. So the beauty of ADS Desktop LVS is it is easily accessible within ADS and does not require an LVS rule deck. Also, it allows you to keep your design IP on your desktop. Desktop LVS runs very fast and allows you to check your design directly in ADS design environment at any time and as often as you want during your design phase. For a free evaluation of ADS and for more information on Mimic Design Flow in ADS, please visit these web pages. Thank you for watching this video demo.